This is a video requested by Silent Hill and a few others. Hey, I'm Ground Robin, or Casey Whitrock, and I'm going to show you how to make a headshot.
And today, I'm going to show you how to do this. Okay, first step, materials. Okay, now, I know how hard it is to make fake blood, because it's sort of a trick and a skill, if I may, to know how to make the perfect fake blood. If you don't have money, you don't want to buy fake blood, what I suggest to do is you get some Karo syrup. You cut that in about half, and then you fill that in a big bottle with water. So you have Karo syrup and water. And just enough Karo syrup where it turns it thick. Not like molasses thick, but thick, like blood is. Just a little bit, you know what I mean. And then that'll also, there's sugar in it, so that means you can put it in your mouth and it'll taste good. Then you just add a ton of red food coloring, just a ton, and just a drop of green. Just one drop of green, that's all it takes. And then that'll make, it'll be the right darkness of red, but it'll be clear, you'll notice. So what you do to fix the clearness, you actually take some chocolate milk powder, and mix it in with that, and you'll have some pretty good fake blood. Not perfect, but it's pretty good in my opinion. I, however, on the other hand, I like to buy my fake blood, although it only comes once a year at Walmart during Halloween. This stuff, right here, it's called pint of blood. You know, I don't know, it's pretty good. It dries on your hand, the dark brown red, and even flakes. I found it scary realistic, like, I'm not sure how they got it that way, if you know what I mean. But yeah, they're like $4 for a quart. I stocked up a couple days ago, since it is Halloween. It's November 4th, and I voted. But, but it's perfect, as you can see. Perfect.
Second material. I just sat in fake blood. The second material you'll need, it's very important, sponges. Or, since I don't have any sponges in the house that my mom will let me rip up, Kleenex! You take the Kleenex, and you'll just rip it up into parts. Rip the one full Kleenex into about 5 different parts. Just crumple them up and stick them in the tube. But a sponge works better. But I don't have any. Another thing you'll need, pesticide sprayer. And if you're really cheap, you'll make the pesticide sprayer with just a sprayer, and then the hose attached to it. And how you do is you'll kink the hose and pump it up and then unkink it. But I like mine a little bit more easy to use.
Okay, I'm gonna teach you something that most videos don't teach you. I'm gonna teach you how to make the pesticide sprayer. So you take the pesticide sprayer, and with this one, I was able to keep the original hose on it. So you take the hose and you get rid of the end that makes it so only a little bit of air comes out at a time. You take that off and you fasten on just a regular garden hose, as long as you need, as much as you need it, it's your preference. Now to make that right there could be as much as you need, but I like to go a little bit further. You take that hose and you stick it to a valve. And that way, instead of unkinking the hose to make it go, all you need to do is turn a switch, and there the blood splats. So you have the first hose hooked up to the valve, and then you just take a second cut of hose, stick it to the valve, and there's your final product. Extremely easy to make. Now, the duct tape I have on the end is only because I don't want it to come out in just one stream. If you put a little bit of duct tape on the end and put it over the hole, it'll splatter it a bit more, creating more of a wide blood splatter effect.
It is the cheapest way to make squibs. I mean, there's no explosives, so it's not dangerous. Extremely cheap. I got this thing for $10.
Super easy to make. Okay, the final part of how to do this. You can use some kind of funnel. I'm using just a small metal funnel, just because it makes it easier to pour the blood in. Take your fake blood. Pour the fake blood in. God, shut the fuck up. Duh. I'm having more trouble with this than I never had before. The that's not supposed to happen. If you use a funnel, get it on your clothes, the stuff washes out pretty fine. Take your Kleenex, rip it up, crumple this up, you stick it in. Make sure you don't use too much. Otherwise, the pressure won't be strong enough. You'll just clog it. And take a little bit of blood and put it on the top, so it's white. Close it up with the tape. Next step, you pump it. A lot. Okay, now I'm gonna be a little cheesy with my arm here holding it. Otherwise, you could have somebody behind you holding it or just tape it to your back. But I'm running short on time, so, and I have no friends. I'm just kidding, they're all at college. And I'm not, because I'm lazy. Well, anyway, this is how you do it.